Good morning, Holy Trinity. Today is Thursday, May 26th, and you're with your host, Jelaine. Please rise for the playing of our national anthem.
Good morning, Holy Trinity. Today we begin with a statement acknowledging the land on which we gather. We acknowledge that the land upon which we gather is the traditional territories of the Haudenosaunee and the Anishinaabe Nations. We recognize that the Brant, Haldimand, Norfolk Catholic District School Board and its schools have many ties to Six Nations of the Grand River and Mississaugas of the Credit First Nations, situated on the traditional land of the Haudenosaunee and the Anishinaabe, within the Two-Row Wampum and the One Dish, One Spoon Treaty areas. As a Catholic learning community and as treaty people ourselves, we strive to build the kingdom of God, where all people are treated with respect and dignity as we move forward, as allies, towards truth and reconciliation.
Good morning, everybody. Yesterday we talked a lot about just those negative thoughts that kind of creep into our mind. You know, it's kind of a negative thing, right? And you're wondering, well, why do we pray like that? Why do we pray all these negative things? And the reality is we don't just, we pray about everything. You know, God wants to hear about all things. He wants to hear about the good times as well as the bad times. And so often if we just sort of hold on to the bad times and try and fix things on our own without bringing those things before God, then we don't actually get those things fixed, because God is the one that can fix those things. So yesterday, I'm going to call back to yesterday, when we were reflecting on those negative thoughts, you know, perhaps one of those things that enter into our minds is worry, you know, and on the opposite end of worry would be peace. You know, so perhaps today we can think about, you know, if worry is something that kind of brings us down, you know, and if you think about a pathway, you know, like something like just, oh, you got a grass lawn and you want to make a pathway from point A to point B. You know, we trudge along that same path for like a year. You know, that grass is going to get trampled down. You know, and if that pathway is leading us down a negative mindset like worry, you know, then it's going to be our go-to comfort path when we try and go from point A to point B. You know, but if we were to sort of trudge a new path, you know, towards this idea of peace in our thoughts, you know, eventually that old path will get overgrown and be like it was never there, right? But we need to recognize that we need to make that new path. So if worry is something we find ourselves constantly entering into, let's place that this morning at the feet of Jesus and seek out peace in our lives. So if you can join me. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. God, as we approach the end of the school year, you know, we look towards exams, we look towards next year. You know, perhaps we are worried about what is to come. Perhaps we get stressed out about our futures. Or maybe we get stressed out about our exams. Maybe our marks aren't where we want them to be. God, we just pray that we hand those things over to you. You know, keep us mindful of the things that we need to do in order to succeed, in order to do our part. But ultimately, God, all that worry that we bear on our shoulders, we place on your shoulders. And we thank you for that. And because, again, Mary is someone who loves to bring peace into our hearts by leading us closer to her son, Jesus, we'll close by praying the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Yesterday, the junior and senior boys rugby team both achieved Kiwassa Gold. The junior team finished their season with only two losses, and this Kiwassa Gold is the first in school history for any junior rugby team. The coaches are proud of them and their incredible season. The seniors now advance to OFSA Championships, which will be held in Coburg next Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, where they will be competing alongside the best schools in our province. Congrats, boys. Will all senior boys rugby players come down to the gym right away for an important OFSA rugby meeting? Grade 12 grads, last chance to sign up and guidance for next week's workshop with a counselor from Employment Services. A career counselor will be coming next Tuesday to meet with students looking for full-time employment after graduation. They can offer assistance with job searches, resume writing, and interview support. There are funds to help you with work equipment, training, and uniforms. Please sign up today. Here's a chance to do some community service in the area of Holy Trinity. Help is needed this Saturday morning to move a disabled adult from a basement. You would be lifting boxes and carrying items up a flight of stairs. Please see Ms. Aiken in guidance if you are able to help for a couple of hours. And lastly, a message from the cafeteria. Today we have breakfast sandwiches and wraps, breakfast sausage, hash browns, cheesesteak, Thai chicken noodle bowl, pizza, the two cheeseburger deal for $7.99, and sundaes. That's all for me, Titans. Now over to Rochelle.
Hey, Titans. This is Rochelle from Council, and I'm here to remind you that you can still sign up for Lemonade House auditions outside with guidance on the Student Council Board. Today and tomorrow are the last day of auditions, but if you cannot attend in person or if you don't have an instrument to bring after school, you can send us a video through Instagram or send us an email on Outlook. And one last thing is that anyone who performs at Lemonade House will get free pizza and lemonade. For further information, you can check the posters that are posted in the halls. Have a great day, Titans.
Hey, Titans. Landon here. Summer is in the air, which means it's time for sunshine, sweet tunes, and cold drinks. And speaking of cold drinks, you guessed it, Holy Trinity is putting on a Lemonade House, a summer spin on our coffee house event.
But Landon, what is Lemonade House, I hear you ask? Well, Lemonade House is a talent show, which will be held on Thursday, June 2nd, from 5 p.m. to 7 p.m. after school.
We all like lemonade, which of course will be served there. But more importantly, a lot of us have unique talents, which is what Lemonade House is all about. So if you're interested, then please consider auditioning.
If you're at all interested in showing off your talents, then you better get ready. Auditions are coming up fast. Wednesday, May 25th, Thursday, May 26th, and Friday, May 27th, auditions will be held in the lower cafeteria after school.
And if you would like a specific time slot, then please be sure to sign up on the Student Council Board in the main hallway near guidance.
Lemonade House, of course, is a talent show, which means any talent, singing, dancing, instrument playing, or whatever other talent you may have up your sleeve is applicable. So, if you have a talent you want to show off, please be sure to audition. And if you can't audition at any of those times, no worries, we got you covered. Just message our Instagram, at Holy Trinity Council. And if you can't get a hold of us there, then don't worry, because you still got options.
Should you not be able to contact us on Instagram, then don't be afraid to email one of our presidents, either Rochelle or Summer, via the emails you see on screen.
If you at all have any talents you are interested in showing off, then please consider auditioning. If not, then come to the show, sit down, relax, enjoy some lemonade, and of course, all the talents. That's it from me, Titans. Good luck to all those who audition, and I hope to see you there.